to the phone. Fantastic. It's our first day on the ward and we can't even find her. She wasn't in her room when I knocked. Didn't look as if her bed had been slept in either. That was why she's so keen to live in hospital accommodation. She's probably nabbed herself a doctor on her way to Bloodford, see?
I know what she's like.
Right, it says go through the main entrance, past A&E and report to the management corridor. Carrie! Sorry, it's my first day.
Yeah, and your life's a bit carry on like that.
If his reflexes had kicked in 1 second later, you'd have been our first real patient.
So what happened to you last night?
I found this pub round the corner from the flats. One thing led to another.
You're meant to be on your best behaviour.
Well, I will be from today.
Oh, again, move on, girls.
In 1 minute, 50 seconds, we'll be late.
Yeah, temperature's very high. She fainted this morning. Dizziness, but no sign of abdominal pain. Oh, and the urine test came back negative for pregnancy. Thanks, Kim. Oh, and the five-a-side's been cancelled tonight. But we can sit at a drink?
Great.
Okay.
Hello, Ella. My name's Dr. Ormerod. This is my registrar, Dr. Chapman.
Hi.
So, what's the problem?
I feel awful, Doctor.
Yeah, it's like she's got flu, but worse. It just came on overnight.
Right, well, let's take a look at you. You don't mind if I examine your tummy, do you?
No.
How long have you had this rash?
Wasn't there this morning.
I can't wait to get my hands on a real patient. I'm so nervous. I just hope I don't make a prat of myself. I've had a chance of that. You're practically Florence Nightingale reincarnated.
Oh. Out the way! You're blocking the corridor.
A civil excuse me, but it suffice, Norman. Thank you, ladies.
Oh, it's so exciting.
There's nothing exciting about being late. Come on. There's an office to find before we get anywhere near the ward.
How long have you been like this?
Since last night. I kept telling her she was overdoing things, but she wouldn't listen.
How's that?
She's only just gone back to work after a boot job.
You've had a breast enhancement operation?
For our wedding. We're getting married in 2 weeks' time.
Yeah, I got this brilliant deal package. Cheap flight to Poland, me surgery thrown in.
There's nothing wrong with a figure in the first place.
Apart from the fact that me dress hung off us. You should see it, it's strapless. These babies, it's gonna look posh-based, Perky.
Yes, I can still see they're quite swollen.
Rock hard.
And the scars are inflamed and a bit weepy.
Ella, I suspect that your blood test will confirm that you have a nasty staphylococcal infection resulting from the surgery.
An infection? I warned you about foreign hospitals.
Now, the infection could have been caused by any number of things. Did the clinic recommend any aftercare?
I was going to bob in to see me GP, but with the wedding, we've been so busy.
If you'd waited much longer, it could have been very nasty indeed.
Oh, but I'll be all right for me big day.
I can't promise anything. First thing we have to do is get those implants out of your body.
But I've only just had them put in.
If we hadn't caught this in time, it would have cost you your life. I'm afraid the implants have to go. Could you ring up theatre, please, Sarah, and book her onto the queue?
Absolutely.
Could you write out some more fluids while you're here, please, Doctor?
Yeah, sure. Look, can you please hold still, Mrs. Bannatyne? That's it.
Okay, you'll feel a lot more comfortable now. There we go.
And can you chase up that mid-elderly bed? This patient needs specialist care. We can't keep reciting that drip. My veins are like lace already.
You just sit tight and don't you fiddle with that arm. I'll be back in a sec, okay?
They're at it again, nurse. They've got no shame.
Thanks, Mrs. Blenkiri.
It's disgusting. They're like animals.
I'm on the case, Mrs. B, so if you'd just like to get yourself and your drains back into bed, that'd be marvellous.
Get out of bed. Get into bed. I can't sling and wee.
Do you want me to go this time?
No. The charge nurse's duty is never done. No. Pass me the riot shield.
Good luck.
Thank you. Phil, Keely. Do you remember our little chat?
We're not actually doing anything.
You won't let me.
Let's have you out of that bed, please, Phil.
I like it. Dead bum.
Oh, it's squashing me.
If I let you two off, the rest of the ward will be at it. Now, please. You're a star.
You see? Harmless, really.
Only because he's taking so many narcotics, he's on another planet.
Mm-hmm.
What's she seeing him?
Oh, it's a tortured artist with a higher consciousness thing. Just like Kate Moss.
Must spend more time in a psych unit than he does at home.
Oh, it must be love. Oh.
personnel have rung down. There's been a mix-up. Because Goodwin Ward's been redecorated, we've been landed with some students.
Ah, oh, could today get any better?
Let joy be unconfined.
The women in the office sit down two floors and turn right.
We're going to have to go back and ask again. How embarrassing is that?
Excuse me. We're looking for Middle Ditch Ward.
Let me guess now. Gemma, Carrie and Leslie and... I'm getting the feeling that you were nearly mown down by a motorbike early this morning.
How do you know that?
Oh, ancient Egyptian spirit guide, Sid.
No way.
No, I was driving a motorbike.
Of course, sorry.
That's all right. I'm Adam Fernley, charge nurse, Middle Ditch Ward, and your very own St. Bernard Rescue Party. Follow me. Stop. Very difficult to find, I'm sure you'll agree. Come on then. Welcome to the war. Abandon hope, all ye who enter here.
Right, I'm afraid this is as far as we go.
I'll be out here waiting. Love you, babe.
Love you too.
I'll take you to the waiting room.
Ella, this is our consultant surgeon, Mr. Woods.
Delighted.
And his registrar, Miss Andrews, and the anaesthetist, Dr. Szymanska.
For heaven's sake, Ormerod, this isn't some damn cocktail party. We'll take very good care of you, my dear. Pamela?
Blood show, elevated white cell count, abnormal electrolytes and liver function.
Let's not hang about. You're correct. We have no time to waste.
I know the doctor said it was urgent, but can we hang fire for a couple of weeks? Only I'm getting married on the 12th.
Delighted to hear it.
Look, I need to keep me boobs. My wedding dress is already made.
Ah, well then I'm afraid that some sartorial adjustment may be necessary. But not to worry, I'm sure you'll be just as charming on the big day. I'll see you in theatre.
Patients use this phone on pain of death, all right? Hospital management prefers them to fork out quadruple charges on their very own personal bedside communication equipment.
Nurse, Mrs. Bannatyne's done it again.
Thank you. I'll be with you in a tick, Mrs. B. Right, you come with me. Heather, can you get her to Med Elderly, please? Pearl, can you take Carrie and Gemma next door? Thank you.
Okay, ladies. Just call me Pearl. I take milk in my tea, no sugar, and I've been in the health service all of my working life. Now, the first thing you have to learn when you come on the ward is forget everything you've been told. Middle Ditch Ward is a law unto itself.
Oh, you're at it again.
I need to find Dr. Ormerod to fix Mrs. Bannatyne's IV.
Don't worry, I'll sort it. They haven't even tried to hide it in the water bottles this time.
Who are they?
Oh, they're a pain in the neck. Phil, he's been in and out for years. He's got psychiatric problems. Not helped by the fact he is always off his head. But we've never had the pleasure of his missus' company before, or her charming family.
So what do?
We brace ourselves and we dive right in.
Hey, Ashley!
She'd have been better off going to her local butcher and asking him to have a go.
Well, the so-called surgeon who did that to her was obviously a man.
How'd you work that out, Doctor?
I'm sorry, but those implants were way too big. They made her totally out of proportion, like some male fantasy blow-up doll.
There is nothing wrong than wanting to make the best of oneself.
Yeah, well, there's making the best of oneself, and there's pandering to the masculine aesthetic ideal, which I'm sorry to say relies heavily on physical features and less so on mental ability. Isn't that right, Mr. Woods?
From it, Doctor. I think you'll find most men of intelligence are less of a cliche and are more inclined to want to embrace the whole woman. It's not as if this girl even needed surgery.
Well, if I had the cash, I'd have the lot done. Teeth, tummy, lipo, facelift, the works.
Yes. I suppose you would.
You know the rules, Phil. There's no alcohol on the ward, so just take it outside.
I don't like it. Being told what to do.
I'm not telling you. I'm asking you. Nicely.
We'll try to have a nice time.
Oh, just do it, Phil. I'll take this, thank you.
Well, we pay good money for it.
Yeah, I give that back.
It's a hospital rule. No alcohol.
What about my human rights?
You can maybe remove this bottle so that these good people can collect it when they leave.
So you can drink it yourselves. I know all about you nurses. Randy as hell when you've had a few.
Could you please stop being so aggressive? We really don't have to put up with this kind of attitude.
Leslie,
Bob that in the locker room for me, please.
You're the one with the attitude, Miss Up Yourself Nurse.
Can we keep it down?
Don't tell me what to do!
If you don't take your hands off me, I will call security.
Dad, please. I've got to stop here. With my anemia, I don't want all the nurses having a go at me.
I'll be back.
Why do you always have to lose it, Phil? Why can't you just behave for once?
Come on, babe.
No respect.
Not now, Mrs. Blenkiran.
I could do this at home. I wonder what Les is up to.
Not finished yet, ladies.
Almost there. So what do we do next?
The lunch trolley is due any minute.
Oh, great, I'm starving.
Patience lunches. And Mr. Carter over there, he won't eat unless you cut everything up for him. Start filling the water jugs, will you please, Carrie?
4, 5, 5. You did say you'd leave me to close up, Mr. Wood.
I know, but if you'll just allow me, the devil, as ever, is in the detail.
Excuse me.
You! No, stop! Give me back my booze.
Crash team. Use that phone there, dial 42s, and tell the operator it's crash call. Move.
Okay, that's 2 minutes. Let's try again.
I didn't do anything. I promise.
That's okay, Leslie.
He was running after me. He thought I'd nicked his vodka. I didn't do anything. Honest.
Clip.
Come on, come with me, come on.
God, men and their drink. It's hard to separate. My father was the same, always with a vodka in his hand. Killed him in the end. Right, we have a pulse, ladies and gentlemen. Let's call ICU and get him a bed, quick as we can, please.
It's always a shock when somebody collapses on you like that.
What happened to him? Is it something I did?
No, I'm sure.
We'll know more once we've gone stabilised in intensive care. He's the father of one of my patients on Middleditch, isn't he?
Yeah.
Right, well, we better let them know.
Okay.
Poor kid. Looks as if she's about to expire herself.
I've seen you look better. Seriously, Jonathan, you could carry a week shopping under those eyes.
3 small children. What do you expect?
That's enough for today, ladies.
Oh, I'm exhausted.
You students don't know what hard work is. When I was a probationer, we used to have to work full-time and study at night. At Matron's beck and call we were. And we didn't have contract cleaners in those days, I can tell you.
Well, we'll see you bright and early in the morning then, Pearl. Thanks. God, when was she a student at Crimean War?
I think that's our card well and truly marked.
What a day. Oh, we were wondering where you usually go for a drink after shift.
The pub across the road. The booze is cheap and the nurse friendly.
Well, fancy joining us for a quick one? You can debrief us about our day.
Yeah. Thanks. I think I will.
What? There's no harm in looking, is there?
I can't believe it. Is he going to be all right?
He's seen the specialist now. They'll be able to tell you more later.
But he was perfectly fine before.
One of you lot must have wound him up.
I assure you that's not the case. He simply followed one of the nurses who took away his bottle of vodka, then collapsed.
The lippy one, with the long hair.
It doesn't really matter who.
It matters to me. You're right!
Dad?
You're welcome to go and see him once he's more stable.
Don't worry, love. You'll be all right. Won't let him get away with it, okay?
Come on.
Ooh, what a charmer.
Yep.
We've started you on intravenous antibiotics, which should begin to fight off the infection.
I'm back to repair fried eggs.
If you've any sense, you'll stay that way. Tell her, Doctor.
It's all right for you. You don't have to live with a chest as flat as an ironing board.
Yeah, but I've never minded, have I? It's not my fault she did this to herself, honest. There's no pressure from me for her to look like Jordan.
So, can I never have them done again?
Well, if you're determined to reattempt an enhancement, I suggest you wait until the infection is fully cleared and the site is healed. I'd also recommend that next time you choose a reputable clinic, which provides adequate post-operative care. Not worth cutting corners when your health's at stake, I'm sure you'll agree.
Of course we do, don't we, Ellen?
And all the best for your big day.
Maybe we could postpone the wedding.
I've waited long enough to marry you. I don't want to wait any longer.
I know, but I just wanted everything to be perfect.
Ella, it's you I want, not your flipping chest.
Even though I'm going to look rubbish in me dress.
I would be proud to marry you, even if you wore a bin liner. I could have lost you today. I could have lost you.
I'll be back on the ward in the morning. Let Sister know if you need any more pain relief, all right?
Can I stay with her?
Of course. Oh, those two are so sweet, aren't they?
Oh. Are you coming for a drink?
Yeah. Just let me hand over first. Mm. Hey, if you were going to have cosmetic surgery, would it be for you? Or would it be for the man in your life?
Hmm. Well, men come and go, but a pair of implants lasts a lifetime.
So he just collapsed right in front of you?
They had to resuscitate him in the corridor. I thought you died.
Oh, you're going to have to lend me £10. All my money's in the room.
Here's 20. Dad slipped me a few quid before I came away. I'll see you in the pub, OK? I left my swipe card in the locker.
OK. You're going the wrong way.
I forgot my card. What an idiot. Drugs down.
Oh, what?
I'll call for help. I'll get the police.
Stay away from me.
I know you're upset after all that's happened today. We can help you properly with proper medication. You don't have to do this.
I warned you!
Doesn't trust us with the patients. We're students, what do you expect? Just things to be a bit more exciting. Where's Les got to? How long does it take to pick up a swipe card?
Oh, yeah? Hey, as it's your first day, I'll buy you both a drink. But don't expect me to make a habit out of it, all right?
Glass of white, please.
A half, please, lager.
Right.
Who asked her?
Don't look at me.
So, how's it been? On a proper ward at last?
Yeah, it's a real eye-opener.
I couldn't believe my luck. First ward I find, and it's staffed by a gorgeous hunk of burning love. Adam?
She's got this thing about men in uniform.
Huh? Any fancy chances, do you?
Please don't tell me he bats for the other side.
I can vouch for the fact he doesn't, seeing as we live together. As in, live together? Share a bed every night. Sorry. Oh, there's no need. I'm used to it.
Right, ladies, drinks. Well, I'm sorry. Did I miss something?
Nothing, sweetheart.
Pretty grim day. Uh-huh. At least we salvaged one girl's wedding. Let's hope she sees sense now.
Well, women see these unattainable bodies in magazines and on TV and want to be the same. They don't realize they could kill themselves for a pair of fake breasts.
Watch it!
Charming as ever. Have you got time for a drink?
Once I've finished in the ward?
Great.
Oh, my God. Jonathan? Leslie? Leslie, can you hear me? Nothing right. I'll get help.
Tonight at 9, Robson Green heads to the U.S.
Motion to strike Dr. Hill as an expert witness because of prior knowledge of my defendant.
Of course he has prior knowledge. That's what makes him an expert.
In a one-off special, Wire in the Blood.